Hi, I'm Errichto and I will show you how to solve problem partition into permutations from Codechef. We are given a sequence of numbers and we can do operations, either insert an element or remove an element. What we want to achieve is that after our operations, the sequence can be split into small permutations, maybe not necessarily taking consecutive interval in the sequence. For example, in sequence 1, 4, 1, 1, 2, we can add a number 3, and then we can split the sequence into 1 and 2, that is a permutation, plus 4, 1, 2, 3, what is also a permutation. For the example on the right, we can add numbers 1 and 1 to get two permutations 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. On the left, we could also, instead of removing, instead of adding 3, we could remove a 4. Then we are left with 1, 1, 2, 2, and there are also two permutations here, 1, 2 and 1, 2. The goal is to achieve a sequence that can be split into permutations in the minimum possible number of operations, and can be up to 1 million, and numbers up to 1 billion, 10 to the 9. I will start by sorting the input, because the order of numbers doesn't matter, and if numbers are sorted, maybe it will allow me to see some observation, or maybe I will be able to do dynamic programming from left to right, or right to left, so smaller to bigger numbers or the other way around. This is often what we should do if the order of numbers doesn't matter. Here I sorted the first sample, 1, 1, 2, 2, 4. And let's think, either can we go with DP from left to right, or maybe when such a sequence is a good sequence, the one that can be splitted into permutations. Both possible approaches here will lead to the intended solution. Let's think, why do we have to do anything with the sequence 1, 1, 2, 2, 4? Well, obviously, a 4 can't be there without a 3. In any permutation, if there is a 4, there also must be all smaller numbers. So I will say, if there is a 4, I also need a 3. Maybe there are two 4s here already in the input. They I need two 3s in the input. And if we try to think about those cases and when a sequence is good or not, we'll see that the number of 1s can't be smaller than the number of 2s, because otherwise there would be a permutation in the split with a 2 and without a 1, and there is no such permutation. Then the number of 3s should be even smaller or equal to the number of 2s, then some 4s, 5s, and so on. Like that. And can we split such a sequence into permutations? Well, a 4 needs a 3, a 2, and a 1. Then we are out of 4s, we take the 3 to 1, and so on. If we go from big numbers and we say, okay, I have a big number that is not yet in any permutation, but I put it with some smaller numbers, if the number of smaller numbers is not smaller, I will not run out of those smaller numbers. And I group numbers like that. Then this 3, 2, 1, and I have last one here alone. That will create a permutation of size 1. So to sum up, the sequence is good if the number of numbers x is not smaller than the number of numbers x plus 1. A reasonable idea here is to try to do some greedy algorithm, even maybe without observations, like removing the biggest value, adding something small if it's needed. But it turns out that sometimes we should insert new numbers, sometimes we should remove them, and it's hard to decide. If greedy doesn't work, after let's say we tried for a few minutes, then the next try should be dynamic programming. Let's see here. We go from small to big values, or maybe the other way around, both makes some sense. And after I considered all numbers up to values x, let's think what is important. Is it important that I took 3 numbers 1, or I inserted some new ones, so I made the number of 1s to be 7? We only care about the decisions made just a moment ago, because I want the number of occurrences of x to be not smaller than the number of occurrences of x plus 1. So what I care about is the number of occurrences of x. Maybe I inserted some nuance, maybe I removed some, but the idea for my dp is to do dp of value, like x here, and c, the count, number of occurrences. From this, I will go to state dp of value plus 1 and some c prime that is not greater than c. If I go to value plus 1 and I want to say, okay, I want the number of those, the count of those to be 7, and they were 3 of them in the input, then I know I need 4 operations. The number of operations to go from some initial count to the current one will be absolute value of difference, that count prime that I want to get, and the current count in the input. Let's say that this is input of this value plus 1. And this will be the absolute value of the difference, the number of operations to get this number of elements. The idea of dp might not look promising here because of big constraints. Value can be up to 1 billion because AI is up to 1 billion in the input, and count can be up to n. It doesn't make sense to make more than n plus 1 permutations, more than n. So let's see if we can cut it down. Can value bigger than n stay in the input? Like, does it make sense to consider 1 billion? If there is 1 billion in the input somewhere, and we want to leave it in the sequence, we would have to also insert all the other values smaller than that to make a permutation. And the number of operations would be roughly 1 billion, which is way too much. In particular, we can just remove all the numbers from the input, so the answer can't be worse than n, and we will not insert more than n elements. The sequence will have at most 2 n elements, so the biggest value there should be is at most 2 n. For sure not more, because there will be no permutation up to 1 billion. So we can say that the value is up to n, actually. Now the number of states is n square, still of course too much for n up to 1 million, and we'll have to do transitions, but it's first step already. Let's say that n is around 100, and we want to know what are possible counts, the number of occurrences, of value 20. Can it be a big number? If we leave 20 at the end in the sequence, there must also be 1, 2, and so on up to 19. For every such 20. 20 must be in a permutation of size at least 20. If I leave at the end x values 20, let's say c values like that, then the length of that final sequence will be at least c times 20 for each permutation of 1 through 20. And it means that c can't be bigger than 5. Actually, it can be bigger than 5 times 2, because we said the answer is at most n, so the final sequence will have length at most 2n. And thus, we can limit the count by 2n divided by value, and only those counts make sense. Otherwise, the final length would be too much, and the answer would be too much. So we don't have to consider that. And you might see something familiar here, because the sum over n divided by 1, n divided by 2, up to n divided by n is n log n. This is a very common thing in algorithms to know this limitation. And it means the total number of states we need to consider is only n log n. We have n log n states. For every value, the counts are up to 2n divided by this value, and we said this sums up to n log n. And now we must do transitions, each transition in constant time, to get the total complexity to be n log n. Then we should write down what should dp value of c be computed as. We already said to get exactly c elements of value v, we should make the number of operations, that is the absolute value of difference, the number of occurrences in the input and the number of occurrences we want. If there are 10 occurrences and we want 6, we need to do four removals. If we want more than there is, we need to do some number of insertions. And we have here absolute value of the difference, count minus in value, in is the count in the input, plus minimum over the previous value we want to occur at least that many times. So we iterate over the previous count bigger or equal to C, and we take dp of value minus 1 d. Iterating over that d would give us quadratic complexity, but we can use suffix minimum or some other simple algorithm, maybe even a segment tree, but then we would have an extra log. It's easier to just do a suffix minimum, where we go with values d and c decreasingly, and in the process we store the best, so smallest value so far, for value minus 1 and d greater than the currently considered c. Let's remember, dp of value c is the number of operations we need to do up to this position, so with numbers up to value, so that the number of occurrences of value would be c. And we need to just code that, it will be n log n. Here's the accepted code. You can see it in my GitHub repository. The link to the problem and to the implementation is in the description below the video. What we do for every test case, because there are two test cases in this problem, I read n, I create a vector to count the number of occurrences in the input, and must remove will be the number of numbers that for sure I remove, because they are bigger than 2n. We said that the answer is up to 2n, so numbers like 1 billion I can just remove. Otherwise, I would have O of billion memory complexity, which is too much. I read n numbers, scanf reads them. If x is up to 2n, I increase the count, something that on the right I called in of some value. Otherwise, I increase must remove by 1. At the end, I will print answer increased by must remove. And how does dp look like? I create dp of size 2n. This will be that first dp I need, dp of 1 of size 2n, this one is the first I create. Then for every new number, for every new value up to 2n, I create an array or vector for the next value. The size is 2n divided by value, plus 1, because we can have exactly this value. Suffix min is initially dp back, and I need to count suffix min on this array, on this previous dp of value minus 1. I iterate over that from dp size minus 1 to 0. I update suffix minimum with this dp. This is dp of value minus 1 and I, so I is the count. And if I fits in the new dp, so the next row, here it would be, we move, for example, from dp of 1 to this dp of 2. If I is smaller than this value, which is dp of size, then we update dp, we not update, we just put the value here, because there was no value there previously. Dp of 2 is suffix minimum, what is here on the right, right here, plus the absolute value of the difference, the number of counts, the number of occurrences we need, I, and the count in the input. Then after we do that, we replace dp with dp2. This way we go row by row, and actually memory will be linear, because I just remember the previous row of dp. Then answer is int max. I take minimum over all possibilities of the last number to n, how many times it occurred, maybe 0, maybe once, maybe more times, if our algorithm allows that. And I print answer plus must remove those big values. I encourage you to solve this problem yourself, and see you next time. Bye bye.